Knowing the proper way to suction your child's tracheostomy is important for their health. Before you begin, gather all the supplies that you will need. All equipment and supplies must be at the patient's bedside before you begin suctioning the child's tracheostomy. For this procedure, you will need suction catheter, appropriate size based on tracheostomy size, a suction machine and canister, a bulb syringe or neosucker, an Ambu-bag, 0.9% normal saline ampules, and gloves. Before you begin this procedure, assess patient's need for tracheal suctioning. Any unexplained decrease in oxygen saturation, color change, or unexplained agitation. There are two ways to suction a tracheostomy, with a catheter and with a plastic bulb syringe. In this video, we will cover both methods. Whether you use a catheter or a plastic bulb syringe, begin by properly washing your hands. First, to suction a tracheostomy tube with a catheter. Begin by opening the catheter package, maintaining catheter sterility. Glove both hands and maintain sterility of the dominant hand. Now, connect the suction catheter to the suction source. Instill 3 to 4 drops of sterile saline into the tracheostomy tube. Pre-oxygenate the child if needed. Note that a child who is able to breathe deeply and cough may not need manual resuscitation bag during suctioning. Using your sterile glove dominant hand, pick up the catheter. Thumb of opposite hand controls the suction port. With your sterile gloved hand, insert the catheter only up to 0.5 centimeter below the tip of the tracheostomy tube. This can be measured against the trach obturator at bedside. Do not force if an obstruction is encountered. Apply intermittent suction by quickly opening and closing the suction port. Withdraw the catheter using a rotating motion. Entire suctioning pass should not exceed 3 to 4 seconds in duration. Lastly, remove your gloves and discard with the catheter. If the child needs it, hyperinflate their lungs with 100% oxygen. Assess effectiveness of suctioning. If ventilatory difficulty or patient discomfort persists, repeat the suctioning procedure. You should always wash your hands after the procedure. Suctioning a tracheostomy tube with plastic bulb syringe. Note, do not rely on bulb suctioning totally for trach care. Deep suctioning should be done when patient first wakes up, and then as needed. Begin by washing your hands. Connect Neosucker to suction apparatus. Place tip of bulb syringe at tracheostomy tube opening. Do not obstruct the entire airway, maintaining the neosucker at an angle. Place your thumb over the suction port and suction until secretions are cleared. Do not suction longer than 3 to 5 seconds without permitting the patient to rest. Rinse the neosucker with sterile water. Store in clean, dry container at the bedside. And obtain a new plastic bulb syringe every 24 hours or as needed. Once you have completed the procedure, ensure your child tolerated the procedure well and dispose of all the materials used during the procedure.